The procedure starts by doing the heart catheterization itself, which is the test to determine if there's a blockage or not. Once we determine there's a blockage, then it becomes a technical issue based on the number of blockages, location of the blockages. Generally speaking, there's three ways to treat blockages. Some blockages are best treated with medication only, and this is in a situation where there's a blockage that nature cannot develop its own bypasses, and we feel that no need for any intervention beside medication. There's some blockages that require open heart surgery, and if that's the case, then we usually stop and get consultation from the heart surgeon to see the patient and evaluate the pictures. And there's blockages that could be fixed with the balloon and stent, and if that's the case, then we usually proceed during the catheterization. So by using the same catheter that we already have to use the catheterization, we'll be able to advance the balloon to stretch the blockage, and we follow that by placing a stent, which is one way to think about it, is scaffolding to hold the blockage to the side and prevent it from collapsing back into the artery. So it's not a general anesthesia, it's not a surgery, it's we give sedative just to treat the anxiety from the natural anxiety facing the procedure. We will gain access to the body either from the groin or from the wrist, which is more common now. We thread a small catheter, which is like basically a big IV into the body, and then use that to thread catheters toward the heart. There'll be a camera on top of the body taking pictures from the outside. When we're done, we'll pull the catheters out, and there'll be no incision. This is just a needle poke, basically, that will either put a small suture or we'll just hold pressure and it seals itself. The only discomfort is when we numb the skin. People will feel a little bee sting from the numbing medication. Having the catheters inside, although it sounds very involved, it does not cause any pain or discomfort. The procedure itself, if it's just a diagnostic catheterization, it's about 20 to 30 minutes or so. If it involves fixing a blockage with the stent, that could be an extra 45 minutes to an hour to the procedure. The recovery from a catheterization is usually observation for a couple of hours. If there is a stent, then we used to be keeping the patient overnight, and now in some cases we'll be able to send the patient that same day, that afternoon, we'll send them home.